It seems to be a very long way from this to a bar of chocolate. Many everyday goods come from the other end of the world and are still frighteningly cheap, which is almost always at the expense of the producers. International corporations make huge profits, whereas the farmers remain poor. Goods and products from fair trade are a good alternative. We took a closer look at five of these goods: tea, rice, carpets, bananas, and cocoa. The range is growing, and there are now 30,000 fair trade products available. As fair trade goods are also offered in supermarkets, sales have increased tenfold. They are highest in Great Britain, Germany, France, and Switzerland. What's in it for the producers? Most of the cocoa for our chocolate comes from Côte d'Ivoire, Ivory Coast. Via the port city of Abidjan, the precious raw material is shipped all over the world. Large export and food companies earn the biggest share in the cocoa trade. But the farmers who grow the plants usually remain poor. Abidjan is the cocoa trade capital of the world. In the 1970s, when prices for cocoa were still almost twice as high as they are today, Ivory Coast was a prosperous country by African standards. But since the prices dropped and growing cocoa became hardly profitable for small farmers, chocolate fans like me, as well as chocolate manufacturers, have to worry about the supply. The warehouses and factories of the cocoa exporters are located on the outskirts of Abidjan. The giants of this industry originate from Switzerland and the USA. Here, on location, some of the cocoa beans are transformed into the raw materials for chocolate, cocoa mass, and cocoa butter, which are then sold to confectionery manufacturers in Europe, for example. For some years now, the trade in cocoa and chocolate raw materials has been in the hands of only a few companies worldwide. This monopoly, in connection with stock market speculation, determines the price of cocoa, and thus the cocoa farmer's income. There's absolute chaos here. Chocolate is a common good in Germany. On average, the Germans eat 11 kilograms per year.
Bonjour. Bonjour, monsieur. Une question, est-ce que vous vendez du chocolat?
Si.
Here, where the cocoa comes from, you can buy chocolate too, but not everyone can afford it.
C'est pour le pain, hein?
I asked him if he sold chocolate. He said yes and showed me this chocolate spread.
Au chocolat. Et c'est du Côte d'Ivoire?
Côte d'Ivoire.
C'est combien ici?
300.
300, oui.
C'est le petit.
About 50 euro cents for a bar of chocolate doesn't sound expensive, but here the average income is less than 80 euros a month, which is why they also sell it in very small pieces for less than 4 cents each. Here's an absurd example for globalization. The cocoa is produced here in Ivory Coast and exported to Switzerland, where it's processed into chocolate and then finds its way back to Ivory Coast. What a mess. Ivory Coast offers perfect conditions for cocoa cultivation, fertile soils and a humid tropical climate with constant temperatures and rainfall at the right time. Originally, the cocoa tree comes from Latin America. During colonial times, the aristocrats discovered chocolate as a luxury drink and status symbol. From the mid-17th century on, almost everyone in Europe could afford to drink chocolate. Chocolate bars weren't invented until about the year 1900. In the mid-19th century, the British and French had cocoa trees planted in their colonies, which is how cocoa came to Ivory Coast. Vurujiri is a small village 7 hours by car from Abidjan and a 3-hour walk from the nearest town. Emma Gureto lives here with her large family. She's been growing cocoa for more than 20 years. The fact that her family now has enough to eat is due to the fact that Emma earns quite well by West African standards, around 115 euros per month. Here in the countryside, many people are very poor. One out of two people has less than 20 euros per month at their disposal. For 4 years, Emma has been a member of a cooperative that buys her cocoa at fair conditions. Emma's husband isn't able to work any longer and has signed over his cocoa field to her.
Qui est Emma?
Hello, are you Emma? My name is Hannes.
Bonjour.
Enchanté.
Ça va?
Merci pour...
Thank you for showing us your cocoa field. I hope we're not disturbing.
Nous voulons pas déranger, mais...
Non, je ne suis pas dérangé.
Très bon.
Emma has 6 children and 10 grandchildren. Her older children attend high school in the city. Her youngest daughter, Charlotte, and her grandchildren go to school in the neighboring village. But it's Wednesday, and there is no school, as is customary in French schools, too. Shall I carry the machete?
Okay.
I wished I could do that. Emma's cocoa field is only 3.5 hectares in size, but the whole family is able to make a living by selling cocoa via Fairtrade. What's this called? I mean the fruit.
Cabos.
This is the first time that I see a cocoa fruit. I've been eating chocolate with joy since my childhood days, but now I see where it comes from. Well, this wouldn't do me any good.
Okay, c'est les fèves.
And these are the beans? I guess you can't eat them.
No. Das, was innen drin ist, heißt
inside of the fruit are the cocoa beans, but it seems a long way from here to a bar of chocolate. Das scheint mir ein sehr weiter Weg. Cocoa used to come from big plantations, but today 90% are grown by small farmers like Emma. Cocoa trees are quite demanding and only develop many fruits if they are intensively cared for. No machine can do that. Cocoa trees grow up to 12 meters high, but they are pruned to a maximum height of 5 meters in order to facilitate the harvest. Cocoa plants don't like direct sunlight or monoculture, which is why there are also palm trees, coffee bushes, and papaya trees. Cocoa trees and fruits are often affected by diseases. Gentle care and biological diversity make the plants more resistant. After 20 years, the old trees have to be replaced because their yield decreases. Many farmers have no money for that, but Emma gets new seedlings from the cooperative. And in training courses, she learns how to best care for her cocoa trees.
Par les formations, ce que me donne à l'école, je viens, j'applique, le champ est changé. Avant, je ne vends même pas 500 kilos. Aujourd'hui, je vends une tonne et quelques.
Working with a machete is dangerous. Often there are injuries. And there are poisonous snakes lurking in the undergrowth. Emma's grown-up son, Bijou, helps with the daily work. At least cocoa growing pays off for the family again. But this is an exception here. Hardly anyone wants to do this tedious work anymore. I'm driving back to town. It's almost 1 hour by car or 3 hours on foot for 13 kilometers. If Emma got hurt at work, the next doctor would be here in town. In the past, many people in Ivory Coast could earn a decent living from cocoa. But because cultivation for the free market is no longer profitable due to the strong fluctuation in prices, hardly anyone wants to become a cocoa farmer. The average age for farmers is 50 years. The young prefer to try their luck in the city. Cocoa fields are recultivated with other plants or lie idle. Knowledge is lost. Cocoa exporters and the chocolate industry are worried about their supply. But wherever fair trade provides decent prices, cocoa cultivation has good prospects for farmers again. It's the end of October. Emma's harvest begins. Unlike her neighbors, she doesn't need to spend money on unskilled workers because the other farmers of the cooperative come to help her. In return, Emma and her son will also be present at their harvest. Two-thirds of the Ivorians make a living in agriculture. Around 6 million people live from cocoa and coffee cultivation alone. Cocoa is the country's most important export article after oil. If cultivation here would pay off again, as it does for Emma, it would be good for the people, the country, and for the consumers, the chocolate eaters. Emma's cocoa trees bear fruit once a year, but they only ripen little by little. The harvest lasts for several months. She's really fast. This is almost lightning speed by African standards. Is this one ripe too?
C'est tout.
There's another ripe one over there.
Il y a une autre, je crois, non?
I always heard how difficult it is to grow cocoa trees. A lot of rain could ruin the harvest, and even if the fruit is struck off the wrong way, it could destroy the tree.
L'arbre c'est vraiment sensible. Comment est-ce que tu coupes les fruits?
Pour couper le fruit, la machette est bien aiguisée. Bien aiguisée pour ne pas blesser le bras, le pied.
Ouais.
Je coupe petit. Doucement.
Et doucement. Hein?
Doucement. Regarde.
C'est lourd, hein. C'est trop lourd pour une fille, hein.
OK.
On y va.
While the adults harvest the cocoa fruits, Emma's younger children and grandchildren are at school. In the countryside, 1 in 4 people can neither read nor write. In Ivory Coast, school attendance is compulsory and free of charge. But do really all children attend school? Until recently, child labor was commonplace in the cocoa fields of Ivory Coast. Many boys and girls had to work for their family or replace adult harvest workers because children are paid only half as much. Meanwhile, the Ivorian state has banned child labor, and the chocolate manufacturers assure that it no longer exists. But is that true?
Un enfant, non, non, on peut pas aller au champ. Un enfant, sa place, c'est à l'école, c'est pas au champ. Voilà. Ici, c'est de, tout le monde a des manœuvres, 2-3 manœuvres. Voilà. C'est les parents qui envoient les enfants à l'école. Ils veulent que les enfants apprennent à lire, à compter, à être bien éduqués et plus tard à travailler. Comme moi, professeur, infirmier, gendarme, policier, comme tout le monde. Quoi.
Je suis venu travailler avec ma chatte.
Mais qu'est-ce qu'il mange au champ? Jeudi, il vient à l'école. Vendredi, il vient à l'école. Samedi, il mange au champ. Dimanche, il met à l'église.
If children help their families when they are off school, it is not considered child labor. But experts estimate that tens of thousands of children in Ivory Coast still work as slaves on plantations without pay. They are hired or abducted by child traffickers in neighboring countries and then sold to farmers who cannot afford adult workers because they are poorly paid for their cocoa. As long as the big food companies and chocolate manufacturers pay dumping prices and we consumers only care for cheap chocolate, the situation for the peasants here won't change. Countless children will continue to be working in their school holidays. But if we're willing to pay more for fair trade chocolate, the farmers and their children will have a chance. The parents do know that it's better for their children to go to school, but the economic circumstances still prevent a lot of people from acting accordingly. The farmers in the cooperative don't require their children to work as they support each other. Now they are preparing the fermentation process by removing the valuable cocoa beans from the caboos.
Emma, est-ce que je peux goûter une fève?
Oui.
C'est possible?
C'est possible. Faut goûter.
Merci. C'est ma coste, non?
C'est doux.
C'est comme un bonbon. Oui. Un petit doux.
Oui, c'est doux.
Hmm. Also riecht nach Schokolade, schmeckt es noch nicht.
Aber das kommt wahrscheinlich.
C'est bien pour la santé, non? Je suis sûr, hein? C'est gesund.
It's very healthy, but I'll wait for the next production step to see if it tastes like chocolate. Who would have thought that the most important ingredients for chocolate look like this in the beginning? But I'm sure Emma will make something of it.
Super.
This is the crucial process. The fermentation determines the quality of the future chocolate. The heat causes the cocoa beans to ferment. It's up to 50 degrees warm, and Emma knows exactly what to do.
Les 6 jours là, c'est un petit secret aussi. Deux jours tu viens tu tournes, deux jours tu viens tu tournes. Après deux jours là, c'est bien fermenté, bien fermenté, pas de problème. C'est le secret qu'elle a là.
During fermentation, the pulp separates from the bean and all the liquid evaporates. One week later, the cocoa beans have developed their typical taste and the right color. They only need to dry in the sun for a few days, which isn't a problem with constant temperatures over 30 degrees.
Okay.
Now the rejects are sorted out, so to speak.
Je veux goûter. Tu prends. On le casse?
Non, on le casse. C'est bien qu'on appelle ça comme ça. C'est joli. C'est doux. On peut manger.
Oh, c'est comme un chocolat maintenant.
Non, c'est pas pour avec le chocolat.
It's got a somehow nutty and chocolatey taste and an exceptional aroma, but it's a lot of work. I'm a bit shocked that we're able to buy a bar of chocolate for as little as 39 euro cents when it takes so many working hours and an incredible effort in order to get there.
Je vais apprécier ce process hier, c'est comme. Il y a une question. Est-ce que tu manges du chocolat?
Je mange du chocolat, mais je ne sais pas comment on fait le chocolat.
This is the cocoa factory in the next town. Usually it's an intermediary who delivers the cocoa here, which is one reason for the small farmers' poor earnings. But what's even worse is the stock market speculation. In 1980, one ton of cocoa almost cost $5,000. In 2000, it was only 1,200, and during the Ebola crisis, it rose to 3,000. Who knows what comes next? Those who work for the conventional market, like these female farmers, are helplessly subjected to these constant fluctuations. All this with a bowl on their heads. Fortunately, they don't let themselves be dragged down.
Est-ce que vous travaillez dans les plantations de cacao?
Oui, oui. Cacao.
Dans la coopération? Le prix pour le cacao au moment?
Le moment, on ne sait pas. On nous a dit 800 CN. Mais dans le village, on paie ça à 700 CN.
C'est toujours le même prix?
Oui, oui. 700 CN.
Ça ne change pas.
Pas le transport là, et puis là-bas. Ça nous, c'est ici, là. 500. Oh, oh, oh! Merci beaucoup. On a ce soir.
Papa, 500 West African francs per kilo. Emma gets one-third more from the cooperative, 850, which is about 1.30 euro. And the cocoa is picked up from her plantation. The two bags, a total of 135 kilograms, earn Emma around 175 euros. That's a good start, as the harvest has only just begun.
Faut voir.
Ok.
Vraiment, c'est très bien fermenté. Okay. Voilà.
C'est très bien.
Ça, c'est du bon cacao projet, ça.
Oh. Ok.
C'est ça, très bien.
Y a pas de problème. C'est très bon.
Fair trade guarantees a minimum price that is always above the current world market price. But critics say that even this is often still too little for a decent living. Emma has to manage her income well. It has to last a whole year.
J'ai compris.
C'est bien.
The cooperative sells the cocoa beans directly to chocolate manufacturers in Europe. Aminata Bamba is one of the organizers. She will show me the warehouse, but I'll have to wash my hands first.
On fait beaucoup de cacao et de café. Donc ici d'abord quand on vient nous luttons contre Ebola. Donc il faut laver la main comme ça. On le fait à chaque fois qu'on rentre dans la coopérative.
Non, j'ai pas peur.
Non, il ne faut pas avoir peur.
Et c'est pour c'est contre le travail des enfants.
C'est contre le travail des enfants. On demande aux parents d'envoyer à l'école.
Ah, ouais. Est-ce qu'il y a des enfants qui travaillent dans les plantations?
Non.
The cooperative consists of about 1,000 smallholders, and there are several storages like this one. Once the cocoa beans are sold, the earnings are split evenly between the cooperative and Emma. For this money, the cooperative offers free advice, does the quality control and organizes the shipments to Europe, for example. Fairtrade cocoa is a bit more expensive for chocolate producers, but it's only a few cents per chocolate bar. Sometimes we have to pay a lot more in the supermarkets, which isn't fair too. Still, the farmers benefit from every Fairtrade cocoa bean that is sold additionally. This increases, for example, the 10% premium for social projects, upon which all members jointly decide.
Et les sacs, ils vont d'où d'ici?
D'ici, ils vont au port.
Au port, à Abidjan. Mais ihr produziert 100% Fairtrade Kakao. Habt ihr genug Abnehmer, um den auch loszuwerden?
Non, pas du tout. L'année passée, nous avons produit 21 tonnes de cacao Fairtrade, mais on a vendu seulement que 6000 tonnes. Donc ça veut dire qu'on a une grande quantité qu'on n'arrive pas à vendre sur le label Fairtrade.
Wow.
On vend ce cacao-là sur cacao conventionnel.
More and more chocolate manufacturers are working with certification organizations such as Fairtrade, Rainforest Alliance or UTZ, which are committed to fair payment, occupational safety and environmental protection. But this is still far too little to make a difference and promote working as a cocoa farmer. Nevertheless, the consultants are fully committed to building a better future for the farmers and their country. Anne-Marie Yao not only shows farmers how to achieve a better yield, she also fights for the equality of women in a society where men still have the say.
Donc on va apprendre aujourd'hui à respecter nos femmes, à les considérer comme des personnes qui sont comme nous. Elles sont intelligentes, elles peuvent éduquer. Si elles éduquent nos enfants, ça veut dire qu'elles sont intelligentes. C'est vrai, non? C'est les femmes qui éduquent les enfants.
Translated into tribal language, the message remains the same. If the men allow the women to simply carry on, everything will improve, which would be good for everyone.
Pour le pays entier, c'est important parce que c'est elle qui se réveille le plus tôt. Elle se réveille avant tout le monde. Elle se couche les dernières. Donc si des personnes qui sont capables d'avoir une telle endurance ont les moyens, ont les ressources, sont éduquées, sont appuyées, ce serait une force extraordinaire. Et elles sont plus douces parce que ce sont des mères, elles réunissent plus la famille, elles sont conciliantes, elles sont flexibles, beaucoup plus que les hommes. Donc je pense que pour le pays, c'est très important.
Emma already started into a better future 2 years ago. For the first time in her life, she had earned enough money to buy a real bed with the help of Fair Trade. It was the first and only bed in the whole village.
Oh, tu as un lit. C'est confortable. Ouais. Et Emma, avant, tu as acheté le lit, tu as dormi...
Voilà la natte, là.
Ah, bon.
Et demain, sous la natte, il n'y a pas de tapis.
C'est mieux comme ça, hein?
Voilà, j'ai payé le lit, j'ai mis le tapis maintenant.
Das ist echt der Luxus. Und sie hat eine Lampe und eine Taschenlampe.
Voilà, ma tasche.
Emma, bist du mit deinem Leben, so wie es jetzt ist, zufrieden?
Oui, je suis contente, très bien. Je suis contente. Mes enfants vont à l'école sans problème. Moi, ma vie a été changée grâce à le projet-là.
Was müsste sich in deinen Augen verbessern und verändern?
Pas l'eau.
Il n'y a pas l'eau. C'est un problème. Hein?
Voilà, l'eau, ouais. Mais surtout l'eau. Quand tu vois mon eau, là, tu dis comment tu bois. Il n'y a pas école. Regarde les petits. Elle a 10 ans, c'est maintenant elle fait CP1. Parce qu'il n'y a pas école. Ils sont, quand ils reviennent, ils sont fatigués, ils ne peuvent même pas étudier. Regarde les petits.
Ouais.
There has been some progress. Emma's children and grandchildren can all go to school, but it's too far away. In another village, the cooperative built an additional school. There could be more projects like this, and people would have even more reason to celebrate. But there's no money for clean drinking water, electricity, or an infirmary. Village chief Henri Tap explains.
Le niveau de vie a changé sur le plan social. Mais sur le plan économique, ça n'a pas trop changé parce qu'on ne gagne pas ce qu'on devait avoir. Tout l'effort qu'ils mettent dedans, puisqu'ils se fatiguent là, est-ce qu'on ne peut pas améliorer leurs conditions de vie, améliorer le prix? C'est ça qu'on vous demande.
Fair trade means more money for farmers and more money for community projects. Emma's life has already improved considerably, but that doesn't apply to everyone here. Unfortunately, fair trade cocoa is still in its infancy. In Germany, only 0.15% of all processed cocoa, which is a shame. We need to change our minds, first and foremost the chocolate manufacturers, but also us consumers. If we buy fair trade chocolate at the supermarket, the farmers here are able to make a decent living from their work and send their children to school instead of the fields.